the building of God, the field of God, and we've been discovering what it means to be the church. We've learned that Jesus is the head of the church. He is the founder of the church, and He is the foundation of the church. And it is Jesus Christ who is building His church. Well, the question we need to ask is, well, how then does the Lord build His church? Do we just kind of sit back and let the Lord build? No, what we need to understand is that the Lord is building His church through us. We are tools in the hands of the master carpenter. He is building His church and He is using us. We have been gifted and enabled by the Holy Spirit to help the Lord Jesus build His church. This is the Great Commission. Go and make disciples, to baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that the Lord Jesus has taught us. It is the Great Commission. We've been discovering what this means, to go and make disciples. And we talked about, well, what is a disciple? Disciple is not someone who comes to a Bible study and just absorbs information. A disciple is one who is becoming like Christ. We are maturing. We are being conformed into the image of Christ. That is God's goal for your life and my life. And God uses different instruments to accomplish that in our life, to make us more like the Lord Jesus Christ. We've also discovered that not only is Christ being conformed in our life, or we're being conformed like Christ, but we have been saved not to sit, but to serve. That every single member of the household, the family of God, is a minister. And so we're going to carry this thought, we're going to move on, and we're going to talk about this morning spiritual gifts. How to discover your spiritual gift. And let me give you a quick definition of what are spiritual gifts, because we need to have something on the floor here in which we can work from. A good definition of a spiritual gift is this: a spiritual gift is an expression of the Holy Spirit within the life of the believer, which empowers him or her to serve the body of Christ, which is the church. In layman's term, it is the revealing, it is the expression of the Holy Spirit in my life and in your life, empowering us to be the hammer, the saw, the nail, the measurer. I go on giving you tool after tool after tool. Not all of us are hammers. Not all of us are pliers. Not all of us are screwdrivers. But all of us are tools in the master carpenter's toolbox. It is the Holy Spirit that empowers us to be used. For our enjoyment? No. For our employment. For us to be used within the body of Christ to serve one another, to build the church. If you look at a church that's not growing, I can tell you the reason. It's not because of the pastor's preaching. It's not because of the music. It has nothing to do with that. Chances are, if a church is not growing, it's because the people within the church, those who say, I'm a member, I'm a part of the family of God, I'm part of the fellowship of God, they're not utilizing their gift. They're not being used to build the body. So this morning, I want to nail this down because, listen, God doesn't want us to be ignorant concerning spiritual gifts. He doesn't want us to be misinformed as to spiritual gifts. And I know sometimes when we start thinking about spiritual gifts, we kind of run off on a tangent. And we focus on all the wrong things. But what I want us to understand this morning is that God is the giver of this gift. And He doesn't want us to be ignorant, foolish, misinformed about spiritual gifts. Look at verse 1. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 1. Paul says, "Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren," he's talking to the Christians, he's talking to the church, the Christians who met in Corinth, alright? He says, "Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I do not want you to be ignorant. You know that you were Gentiles carried away to these dumb idols." Corinth had a problem with idolatry. The city was just infatuated with idols. And Paul is saying, you know, when you were before you were a Christian, before you were the church, when you were a Gentile, you were carried away, you were following these dumb idols. However you were led, therefore I make known to you that no one speaking by the Spirit of God calls Jesus accursed, and no one can say that Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Verse 4, there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are many different gifts, but there's only one Spirit. There are differences of ministries, but the same Lord.